Hi everybody, I'm August Bryce from Tech Wellness. I posted a video on Fitbit EMF radiation that turned out to be very popular back in January. Updating it today, I want to tell you about the big Fitbit recall. Stories are all over the internet. Fitbit recall due to mysterious EMF Wi-Fi symptoms, and that complaints are mounting. You may have heard about it, and you probably thought it was a pretty big deal, right? Just this week, a very brilliant, health-conscious friend of mine with her own healthy living blog sent me a text with a link to the story. And you know, she was really concerned, and I am too. The real problem with this serious Fitbit EMF recall? It's just not true. Wait until you see how you might have thought it was true. I talked to two people at Fitbit, and you'll hear what they said about the EMF Wi-Fi recall. But first, let's talk about EMF, or electromagnetic fields, particularly the kind coming from the Fitbit. Radio frequency radiation, or RF. This EMF is emitted by all wireless devices, and in the case of Fitbit, it's from the Bluetooth connection. This is the EMF that I'm particularly sensitive to, and on our site, Tech Wellness, we have details in our knowledge section about EMF radiation, EH, and symptoms. So you know what? Please visit if you want to know more. So the Fitbit video with the fun wireless demo and the blog were posted in January, and 3 months later, my video was in other people's blogs, and a bunch of people started writing stories about Fitbit EMF. And this EMF Wi-Fi recall. Now, I didn't talk about the recall in my story from January, but in 2014, people were getting rashes on their skin right where they wore their device. Fitbit offered refunds and blamed the problems on either the metal or the plastic adhesive used on the backing. That was 2014, flash forward. 2018, 4 years later, new Fitbit radiation stories were appearing online with a focus on the recall because of EMF. Fake news, see how it happens, so you can make sure you're not a victim of it. This headline, Fitbit recall due to mysterious EMF Wi-Fi symptoms, complaints mounting, appeared on Natural Blaze the end of March. In the story, the writer explains how she started getting painful electrical pulses after wearing a Fitbit she got for Christmas. Now here's where she got the radiation and the recall idea. She quotes an article from a few days before in the Activist Post. Fitbit recalls due to rashes, reports of dizziness, erratic pulses, nausea, pain, headaches. Fitbits operate using Wi-Fi. Whoop, there it is. It really said that. This kind of writing is often referred to, because it's kind of scary, clickbait. It's so intriguing that you want to read it, and when you do, when you go click on it, you'll see a post that's usually advertising something. The Activist Post is full of paid advertising, but it wasn't exactly fake news. When the Natural Blaze headline 3 days later appeared, Fitbit recalled due to EMF Wi-Fi symptoms, that was fake news, and it's really sad. The only recall was the 4 years ago. And this is a new story, so of course you think this is a new recall. And because one website decided to run this story, this fake recall story is all over the internet. Even HealthNet News posted the story in May with the same Fitbit recall due to EMF headline. And sadly for Fitbit, it has over 43,000 shares alone. I called Fitbit, talked to two people, including a supervisor. There was no recall. Fitbit said if there was, it would be on the website, and it would likely be on the Consumer Product Safety Commission site too. The truth about this story, and this is my point and the mission of Tech Wellness, is to shed light on the very confusing, misunderstood, and complicated topic of EMF. It's exciting and people want to find out about it because it's scary. What it is and its effect on our bodies. The truth is EMF, without a doubt, has a biological effect, and definitely some people are sensitive to it. And most definitely, there is research connecting cell phone radiation with serious disease like cancer. Some say the potential risk from Bluetooth compared to cell phone radiation is much less because of the lower power. But the Environmental Health Trust says there isn't a level that has been proven safe. Tech Wellness is not about hype. It's about sharing research and knowledge about tech toxins, like blue light, radiation, tech addictions, and security and privacy, and offering you some simple solutions. The solution that we talked about in our Fitbit radiation video and in our popular blog post was this. If you notice any symptoms from any smart device, take it off and see if you feel better. And for people that are immunocompromised, have EHS, or just want to take healthy precaution, don't wear a wireless device. The lesson here is that you really should be careful about the power of the internet and what you're reading online, especially when it comes to your health. I'm August Bryce with Tech Wellness. Please, if you like this, give me a thumbs up. And if you made it all the way through, I'm going to give you a thumbs up. Be well. I'll see you next time.